It's easy for you to look at a man and say this man is a wicked man, harsh to all his children, until you find out the story of that man's anger. You will find out that at 18, that man was one of the most gentle person you will ever find. But all the siblings and everybody died, and they left him with 30 children to raise all of them. That was the origin of that anger. The anger was in him, but there was nothing to activate it. And because it was not dealt with by the strength of the Spirit, the presence of 30 children versus their school fees, and a job that is the salary keeps declining, is what activated that. No wonder a couple will get married and a woman will turn and say, this is not the man I married. Let me tell you, that's the man you married. It's just that what the activation system. When you see a man nice to his wife and say, I will never touch you, he's talking nonsense. If you are speaking by the agency of the Spirit, you are right. But if you mean just because I love you, keep watching. Your heart is listening to you. The day that something will happen, a man called me one time. I think there was a year that the man reached me. True story. A small boy went to kick a car. Kick the man's car, you know, children and all these their things, and he just crashed the car through a fence. The man was thinking of how to beat and kill this child. How do I start? It's not whether I would do it. I'm thinking of how I'm going to start killing this child. So when you are an onlooker, you will say, what kind of an angry man is this? Whereas the same thing in him is in you, waiting for an opportunity to come out. Why is this person jealous? Why is there jealousy among men of God? Why can't they just walk as one? Don't worry, say you're about to start ministry. By the time you start ministry and after 10 years you have only 3 members, you will know why people get angry. This is not an issue of good or bad. It's an issue of the human nature that has not been examined to be understood. Ta-da-da, ta-da-da. When you go to pastors' conferences and you see men of God crying, the man of God just raises a song of worship and you see a pastor rolling. Let me tell you why he's rolling. He's rolling because after 20 years of ministry, he does not even understand himself again. He's sitting before the presence of God and saying, Lord, who am I? You have to answer me now. I thought I knew myself 20 years ago, but right now I don't even know who I am again. Let me tell you sincerely, everything you ever see that manifests did not come in. It was always there. But there is a system God has provided to be able to tame the flesh with understanding. Not in the strength of the flesh. Taming the flesh in the strength of the flesh is a total waste of time. It's like trying to push a wall. You are the one who will be tired. Is someone learning now? Apostle, me, I'm a man of integrity. What has tested you? Apostle, I don't like with me the kind of grace God gave me. If I see women, they are like trees. And men too, vice versa. Even if 1 billion naira is given to me, I won't collect it. And your heart is saying, it's because we have not gone together. It's only your mind that has gone. That's why your mind refused to collect it. Let your heart follow your body when you see that money, especially when your loved one is in the hospital, saying, my son, is this how you will leave me to die? Then you will now know why the young lady started following one man for money, and mercy will be in your heart. You will no longer say, all these ladies moving around, because you had the privilege of a family that could support you. I'm not excusing licentiousness. You get my point. I'm revealing to you something about the state of man. So many people say this guy just became bad, or this pastor changed, or this businessman changed. No, you got it wrong. In iniquity did my mother conceive me. By the time you start a revival, you know, most people who start ministries, maybe fellowships and the rest, provided it's a small fellowship where people meet under a tree, there's no reason for jealousy and pain and what, everybody's just praying. So you pray, there's no basket to drop offering, so there is no thief to pick anything. But that does not mean among the prayer warriors there is no thief. Generational curses, demons and wicked spirits hiding while you are praying. And the day somebody comes and says, I want to donate 500,000 to this small fellowship. Someone will say, what? Was Judas always bad? You are wrong. Yes. The problem is that what was in him? Do you know the kind of screening he must have gone through to be Jesus's treasurer? Remember, Jesus prayed all night before he got the disciples, and not even Peter was given the basket. You don't know the kind of offering people gave Jesus. That's why you are talking, a woman who comes to break 1 year's salary at his feet. Look at Gehazi. When Gehazi saw what they gave Elisha, Gehazi went back and said, hold on, please. My master is a stupid man. He doesn't know that I work with him. Even if you don't want, must you? A king gives you this gift. And Elisha said, was my spirit not with you? So Jesus looks at Nathanael, who just finished criticizing him, and hear Jesus's verdict. He's an Israelite indeed, in whom there is no guile. How could you say that about that man? There are many people today who look like drunkards. But let me tell you, they are more of stature in terms of the purity of their heart than several people. Because by their strength, they have tried to patch away a lot of evil. This is the one that trapped them. But there are many people who were born again. It was with scripture they came out. They came out with their father prophesying on their mother, you shall not die. That's how they came out. And from that day, and still in the atmosphere of the anointing, only God knows the possibilities that is within their hearts. In iniquity did my mother conceive me. Listen, this revelation bar puts you in a position immediately where the presence of God does not become a church thing again. In other words, you are saying, Lord, I don't even know the variety of tendencies that are hiding within me. Apostle, I don't drink. I will never drink. It depends on what was given you before that time. It's all this thing that causes ill health and death. Will you drink it? Your fear alone will make you look like you are disciplined. There are many people who are not disciplined. They are just afraid. And that fear is because of ignorance and low-level orientation. By the time you enter a king's palace and see the delicacy that is in a king's palace, you will respect Daniel for saying he purposed in his heart that he will not corrupt himself with the king's meat. Before you say amen, find out what is the king's meat. Have you seen a king's table before?